You're watching Left, Right and Center. I'm Nidhi Razdan. Tonight, the UP government comes under fire for its controversial decision to withdraw charges against terror accused. The High Court has stepped in. Is the SP government playing politics with terror? That's our first focus tonight. And with less than a year to go for the general elections, the center decides to set up 5 central universities that will reserve 50% of their seats for minorities. Is this appeasement politics or is there a genuine need for these institutions? Those are going to be our big debates tonight. But first, UP Chief Minister Akhilesh Yadav's bold promise to withdraw cases against those falsely implicated in terror cases has been controversial from day one. But now it's run into serious trouble with the courts. The Lucknow bench of the Allahabad High Court has questioned the move and given the state time till tomorrow to respond. Anand Sonani has more.
Akhilesh Yadav's attempts to fulfill his bold promise of withdrawing cases against innocent Muslims charged with terror has been cut short by the Lucknow bench of the Allahabad High Court. The court now wants to check the legality of these decisions and has asked the government if they've checked with the centre before withdrawing the cases, since most anti-terror laws are central laws. Khalid Mujahid could have been the first terror suspect whose case would have been withdrawn, but he died a mysterious death in a police van. His death set off demands for taking back terror cases against 14 other accused. The government obliged by asking to withdraw the case against alleged Houthi operator Shamim, already charge-sheeted in the Varanasi blast case. But now the High Court has thrown in a spanner. Meanwhile, in another face-saver, the findings of the government-appointed R.D. Nimish Commission were hurriedly accepted. The Commission's report that had been gathering dust for almost a year raised serious doubts about the manner in which Khalid Mujahid and Tariq Qasmi were arrested.
For any kind of investigation to begin into the illegal arrest of Khalid Mujahid and Tariq Qasmi, and the torture that they were subjected to in illegal detention.
जो निमेश आयोग की रिपोर्ट है, आज कैबिनेट ने स्वीकार की है, और अगली विधानसभा में एक्शन टेकन रिपोर्ट के साथ टेबल की जाएगी.
The Samajwadi Party rode to power as a result of a massive consolidation of Muslim votes that constitute almost 1/5 of the total voting population in Uttar Pradesh. The concerns of the community are paramount for Akhilesh Yadav, and the withdrawal of terror cases is one of his biggest political commitments to them. So when a new hurdle crops up in fulfilling this promise, there is a growing perception in the minds of the Muslims that this promise was always meant to be broken. With camera person Ramesh Varma in Lucknow, Anand Zanani for NDTV.
And so, is the UP government playing politics? That's our first question tonight. Or is it basically trying to undo what has some say has been injustice to those that may have been falsely implicated in cases? We have senior Samajwadi Party leader Mr. Kamal Farooqi joining us first tonight. Mr. Farooqi, there were some serious questions raised by the Lucknow bench of the Allahabad High Court. Does the SP see this as a serious setback at this point?
No, it's not a setback. We'll take a we honour the court's any comment or judgment. We'll take appropriate action. Tomorrow we'll file our affidavit. But the main, people are mixing up two things, in fact. One is the cases which we are withdrawing, which were filed by the past government, unnecessarily implicating the Muslim youths into some small crimes, and then they put it into the all kind of criminal cases against them. There are almost 190 such cases. But out of them, 140 we are recommending that these are the cases wherein they are now.
But they have in this case, small criminal cases. These are terror cases.
They have nothing to do with the terrorist activities, one.
So that's a separate issue.
This is to be a separate. As far as these terrorist activities are concerned, over a period of time, we have seen not only in UP, across the country, the Muslim youths have been falsely implicated into the cases like Makkah Masjid or the Malegaon or even the Samjhota Express or even in Mumbai. They were falsely implicated. Likewise, this particular case also falsely implicated. These two youths were picked up not from the Barabanki but were picked up in from their Azamgarh area. They're absolutely innocent people, and the people say.
But is that something the state government should decide or
no,
the
state,
courts should
state
decide?
No, state government definitely has got a right to review it, but it has to be under the law, and we cannot cross any limits. So. On one side, we have got a commitment that yes, We have to do justice to the innocent people. At the same time, we have to follow the procedure. We are following the procedure.
But it's the courts that have observed in the past. Only a few months ago, the High Court said, how can the government decide who's a terrorist? Let the matter be decided in court. So, isn't there a very dangerous line that you are crossing here?
No, no, we are not crossing the lines. We know our limitations as well. But we will take it up in the court properly. Don't worry about that. We don't have the key wherein we will unlock the people and say that out from the jail. It's not like that. We have to follow a procedure. We are following the procedure. We have committed that we will take an action. Even the Nimesh Commission report, which the people, the Muslim organization were asking, we did not constitute that commission. It was done by the previous government. The Nimesh Commission report, I'm pretty sure it has got something wherein something has been said about the youth, but I am not in a position to say anything.
Okay, we've got the BJP Sudhanshu Trivedi joining us from Delhi. Sudhanshu, do you see this purely as a political matter? Because there is a very important fact that Mr. Farooqi has stated, that there have been people who've been wrongly put behind bars in the past, and they're only trying to watch out for those cases where they believe people have been falsely implicated, where the government feels it's in a position to withdraw charges. How would you look at this?
As far as this matter is concerned, there are two aspects. One is the legality of the situation, another is the political intention behind it. First of all, if you look at the legality of the situation says, if it at all it is right or wrong, if somebody is falsely implicated, let the court decide. I would like to ask, there are thousands of cases in Uttar Pradesh which are pending, in which innocent people are behind the bar. Is this government sympathetic about all those things? Second thing, as far as the political intention is concerned, the entire track record of the Samajwadi Party governments, not government this, the, all the previous governments, is withdrawing the support, these cases from the criminals, right from Phulan Devi's case in the last 1993 government and up till now. And the second intention is, why this sympathy towards the youth of a particular community, that is the Muslim community, has emerged at the time of election? So the time of the event and the political intention, and also I would like to refer one more thing. Samajwadi Party chief Mr. Mulayam Singh Yadav, during the UPA 1 regime, at the time of when the Simi was being put under suspension, they have said that Simi is not a terrorist organization, they are the cultural organization. Finally, the ban was imposed by the court. So when the party is having this type of track record, this type of intention, and they are just before the election doing this,
Mr. Farooqi, quick response to that. You play
absolutely with fire. Number one, I do not know which election he's talking about. Are the elections around the corner? But
they are less than a year away.
2014. And number one. Number two, we won the election on commitments. We won the election on the basis of the manifesto wherein we had committed that all the innocent youths would be released if they are
found
innocent.
But how do you know they're innocent? No. There's no court that has determined that.
Wait for the Nimesh Commission report. That was appointed. And all these cases which I'm talking about, none of them is the terrorist involved. And as I've already said, that we will follow the procedure of the law. And BJP friend, they are talking about all these things wherein in Gujarat what they have done for even the prosecution is, was it the kind of cases, ultimately the Supreme Court forced them to take the cases outside because they were not getting the justice. So they need not to say about teach us all those things. But first, their own track record is very, very bad. As far as we are concerned, yes, we are for the betterment of the minorities, that is whether you call it politics or you call it coming to the people who are suffering. We will do that, be it the education, be it the employment, be it the innocent people arrested. We are committed to that. We'll do that.
Okay, let me get senior lawyer Dushyant Dave, who joins us tonight from Ahmedabad, and then Dr. Abhishek Singhvi of the Congress is also with us. Dushyant, is this a minefield that the Samajwadi Party is walking on? How do you see it?
Well, it's not a minefield in that sense, because there is no doubt about the fact that in many of these cases, innocent people have been implicated. In the past, they have been implicated, even in present, and I'm sure they will be implicated in future. And it doesn't happen only in India, it happens in virtually every country in the world. You have seen even in United States this is happening. But the real issue is that unless and until, it appears that in UP there is some kind of a inquiry which has been conducted by an independent commission. I don't know how far it is true and how far, the material has been examined by that committee. But I would have been definitely very happy if each of these cases were handled by a committee of former judges of the High Court. and they had really given an opinion in respect of each of the cases, because the fact of the matter is that government's power to do this is absolutely without doubt, you know, exists. It is being done, you know, here it's being done very boldly and openly. In Gujarat, as somebody rightly pointed out, I think Mr. Faruqi, you know, large number of cases, those people who were involved with the Bajrang Dal, BJP's other outfits, were exonerated by using public prosecutors who were actually members of VHP and other organizations, and the judges really fell into the trap and allowed each one of them to go scot-free post-2002. So this is an extremely disturbing trend. I am really not sure where the truth lies. But fact of the matter is that yes, young people are implicated many a times by the police authorities wrongly. There is no way to check within the police organization as to whether the arrests have been made on some valid and germane considerations. So this is kind of a rebound of that. And you'll have to take it, somebody will have to examine, as Mr. Faruqi says, if the they are going to follow the law. Nothing wrong about it. I don't see that there is anything seriously wrong about it.
But Dr. Abhishek Singhvi, who should decide that? Should it be the court or should it be governments? Who should decide who's a terrorist and who isn't?
No, I think we need to step back and look back, in fact, all the way back to TADA. It was found in TADA itself that not only was the conviction rate very low, but a huge number, in fact from Gujarat, a large number of mere farmers had been picked up. When that was found, in fact, at that time, if you go back in history, a committee was made. And it has to be always an executive committee, because the power of withdrawal or the power of prosecution, withdrawal from prosecution, lies with the executive. Now, in an individual case, of course, it can be misused. But that power definitely exists is point one. Point two, in the past, right from when TADA was created, one of the major reasons for repealing TADA, one of the major reasons for our opposition to POTA was this kind of misuse. Thirdly, I think perhaps, and I'm guessing to an extent, perhaps what the UP government has done may not be wrong at all, but they have not been able to project it or present it appropriately. Because if there is in fact a case-by-case appraisal, if there is a going into and sifting through the facts of each case, and then a reasoned conclusion is arrived at, that should be made public, it will inspire confidence. I think the feeling is that it is not inspiring confidence, that it is done in a quick manner, hush-hush manner. On the contrary, there is no doubt about the power. It should be done where injustice has been done, but it should be done in a fair and transparent manner. And even though at the moment it is not a judicial body doing it, at the moment, whatever they've done should be made available in terms of sifting through the case and giving reasons why each person is not to be prosecuted.